Good day, everyone. My name is Melvin, boss of Wellland Machinery. Long time no see. Today, I want to introduce this jaw crusher to you, to tell you how to choose a good quality jaw crusher. As you can see, next to me, this is a very common jaw crusher. It's our 6-9 model jaw crusher. It can produce 150 tons per hour. So today, we will take this one machine as an example to tell you everything in details. First of all, we need to pay attention to its wearing parts. We call that tooth plate or the jaw plate. One is movable and the other is fixed. We are currently using magnet 13 chromium 2 material, to which we have added a chromium element. We'll increase the service life by at least 20%. Some factories, they will use magnet 13 material without the chromium, which is not good, or even magnet 6 material. So if you are a current owner, of course you want to get a quality machine and save the production cost. If you want to get a higher level material, we can provide magnet 18 chromium 2 material, longer service life. Then we move to the side protector. It's also magnet 13 chromium 2 material, protect the body of the machine. Then the jaw head protector. This is very important. It can protect the jaw head when a stone fits into the jaw crusher. Because the jaw head is cast, if it breaks, it cannot be repaired. You have to replace the whole jaw head, which almost 30% the cost of the whole machine. Lots of money. But some factories, they will not equip this to save the cost. Okay, when we talk about the casting technology, we need to pay attention to one thing. Remember to choose the jaw crusher is welded, not casting, okay? Because like what I said before, the cast is cheaper, but it's not durable. If it breaks, you have to change it whole. So remember to choose the jaw crusher is welded with the steel plate, not cast, okay? Then we talk about the motor wheel and the flywheel. The function of the motor wheel is to transmit the power from the motor to the jaw head. And the flywheel is for the counterweight for the both sides of the jaw head to prevent the bearing damage. Okay, so here we have to pay attention to two things. One is the thickness of the wheel, and another thing is the counterweight. First, let's have a look at the thickness of our motor wheel. Have a look here. So this is our thickness. Okay, so some companies, some factories, they will reduce the thickness of that. That means they will reduce the belt here. So when the jaw crusher works, so the load of each belt will increase a lot. Then the belt may break easily, causing the safety accident. Okay? Another thing I want to talk about is the counterweight block over there. The counterweight block, it is very important. But some factories, they will reduce the weight of that. So when the jaw crusher works, inertia of the jaw head will decrease. Then the load of the belt and the motor will increase, consume more electricity. Then we talk about the safety device over here. So there is a toggle plate over here, between the body and the jaw head. It's a safety device for the jaw crusher. When a super hard material enters the jaw crusher, such as iron or other material, so the jaw head and the motor will have very huge load, which may damage the jaw head. So at that time, the toggle plate will break to protect the jaw head. For the main shaft here, we use 45 CRMO material plus the moderation heat treatment. But some factories, they will use 45 steel without the heat treatment. Then we talk about the bearing and the motor. Here is the bearings. We use ZWZ bearings, which is one of the top three famous brands in China. For the motor, we use Lu'an and Deshengxiang brand, which is also most famous brand in China. Okay, these things above are the things I want to tell you, and you need to pay attention to when you choose a good jaw crusher. Additionally, I want to say something to you. Firstly, remember to choose the factory instead of a trading company. I'm not saying the trading companies, they are not good, but for the machines, they are good at the service, not the quality control. They do not have engineer or even the after sales teams. How can they do the installation or the maintenance things? Secondly, they need to buy from us the factory first and then sell it to you, right? So some customers will ask me, okay, Melvin, why the price of Welline is higher than the trading companies? Welline is a trading company? I said, no, because they are not buying from us. They didn't buy from us. If they buy from Welline, the price, obviously, they will higher than us because they buy from a cheaper factory, the stone crusher, and sell to you. Do you trust them? Do you know the factory? You don't know. So that's what I want to say. Again, thanks for trusting Welline Machinery. If you need a stone crusher, contact me.